Yes, hi everyone, and welcome to another IFR video. In this video, I will show you how to set up a GPS RNAV approach for an airport. Now, for those of you who have already seen my other video on that, I was showing you one way to set it up, and in this video, I will show you another two ways, although I will just introduce one way very quickly, because the other way I will show you is one of the most common ways to do it. So two methods today of how you can set up a GPS RNAV approach in your GPS unit. In the other video there's another method that I show. So we are using the Garmin GPS 500. That's the one that comes with the flight simulator software. As far as handling the GPS, they are all very similar to each other, depending on which one you use. You have different configurations or setups of the unit. Quick review here. We have the nearest button giving you the first page, and the first page will give you the nearest airports that are around you. Okay, and if we want to go through the list, you have to press the cursor button, as I just did. And then you have to use the big cursor or the outer ring to go down the list. As you can see here, it shows you a variety of airports that are in a certain radius around you. Also Kilo Delta, Echo Delta, which is the land just to the west of the Daytona airport, and so on. Today we will load an approach for the Daytona Beach airport. And in order to do that, we could use the nearest airports list, but it's the Kilo Delta Alpha Bravo airport, which is Daytona, is not included in that list, so there is no way of doing it this way. But that would be one of the methods I want to show you. So you go through the list, and if you have one, what you do is you press enter or direct, and then it will it will understand that you won't choose that airport. So besides that, you can, with the small cursor, you can switch pages here from to nearest intersection in a second, nearest NEB, nearest VOR, and nearest airspace. Okay, so again, that would be one method of doing it. The other way is we go via direct, and we do that in just a moment. So the other buttons here include flight plan. We have no active flight plan. We'll get us back to the map. If you press it again, we have terrain. Okay, terrain will give you different modes, night and day mode. If we press it, we have a day mode. So the display is differently colored for day flying, and if we press it again, we'll go back to night modus. Procedure, PROC, standing for procedure. Here we will select our approaches in just a moment. Enter, that's just like your enter key on your keyboard to confirm things, basically. Clear to delete or go way back or whatsoever. It depends on what you're doing at the moment while you're using clear. Menu is not an option right now as we have no active legs. And then direct. And the range, where you can zoom in, zoom out of the map, increasing, decreasing your range or your radius. Okay, so here, let's come to the method or the way we would like, that I want to show you today. So here's our position, just west or northwest, west-northwest of the Daytona Beach Airport. Remember, we are currently heading south at a 180-degree magnetic heading. And the approach we will be using today is the RNAV GPS 1.07 left. That's the one that we would like to load, and I will show it to you really quick here. RNAV GPS 1.07 left. Okay, as you can see here in the plan view, this is the approach. We have different initial approach fixes. One would be guano interception. Coquette is also an initial approach fix as well as an intermediate fix. And we have Foleg as our final approach fix, and here we have the dashed line would be our missed approach procedure. Okay, the approach will start here at 1700 is the altitude we have to hold till we get to Coquette, and so on. Final approach fix marked with the star. Again, this is a NACO chart, and so on. So back to the flight simulator. So how do we do this? We go to direct, okay, and now we have this black box, and it wants us to put in the identifier for Daytona. So what we have to do here is press the cursor. No, that's not what I wanted, I'm sorry. So here we go, press the cursor. No, it doesn't do it. Sorry about that. Actually, we don't have to press the cursor. What we have to do is use the cursor to turn it, not press it. We use the small ring and turn it clockwise or counterclockwise, and then we have the first position, and we will scroll through the alphabet, but it's beginning by with the digits depending on where you are. So we need a K here. Okay, next position you will change with the outer ring, big cursor, and again back to the small to get the letters, kilo, delta, so we need a D now. Back to the big one, next position is an A. That was actually way too far, I'm sorry about that. A, and big cursor to go to the last position and have a B. Ah. Here we go, Kilo Delta Alpha Bravo, Daytona Beach International. That's the one that I would like to go to or shoot the approach to. Now, what you should not be doing now is press the cursor again, because if you do that, it will go back to your initial setting. So whatever setting you had before this input, okay, it might be before we had nothing, so it would go back to actually empty, or it would go back to another airport if you had a different airport selected before this input. Okay, so what we do, we confirm that by pressing enter. Now the whole identifier is flashing, that's great. What do we need next? Next thing we do is we go to activate by using the small, the big cursor, the bigger outer ring, and we turn it clockwise as long until we have activate flashing. This is great, that's what we need. So it's flashing, and we confirm that by pressing enter. And here you can see the GPS unit just drew a direct line from our current position direct to the Daytona Beach Airport. It shows us that we are 18 nautical miles away from our current point and would take us about 10 minutes to get there. And here we have some more information. The bearing, the direct track to that airport from our position would be 0, 9 or 8 magnetic. Estimated time of arrival 19:22 local, and so on. Okay, so but we wanted to load the approach. So the next thing after we have chosen the direct airport to go to, we go to Prague, and here we have only one option available, as we have not selected an approach. We need to do that first. Select an approach. It's flashing. That's great. So we hit enter. Okay, so for those of you who have seen my other video, I started at this point by selecting an airport in this box and then went to approach. Since the GPS unit already knows which airport we are interested in, it will automatically go to the approach box and opens the list. So we will have to go down to our desired approach, which is RNAV 1RW07 left. That's great. So we confirm that again, confirmations with enter, and then it's going to switch immediately to transitions. How would we like to transition to that airport? Since I've previously used the vectors method, I will now go ahead and use an initial approach fix. Before I showed you the approach plate, vectors, of course, is if you would get headings assigned by ATC to your final approach course. That's not the case right now, or we pretend that this is not the case, so we will have to choose a initial approach fix. So we have guano, almond, or coquette. Almond, I will show you the picture again really quick here of the approach. Almond is not an initial actually, it's just a point from which you can navigate to your initial approach fix of coquette, but we will be using this one, guano, right now. So we'll go use this big cursor to go to guano, as it's flashing, enter, transition guano, and here you already have a top-down view or layout of the approach with our initial approach fix here. So if you're completely sure, yes, that's what I want, and you don't want to review the approach on your map, you can go to activate directly. If you would like to review it, we can choose load, okay, and enter. And now it will give us an active flight plan. Here it says direct to Daytona. That's how you can read it, direct to Daytona via the following approach. Run RNAV runway 07 left. Guano interception, coquette, full leg, our final approach fix. And if you press the cursor as I just did, you can go down these waypoints. But it sometimes does not do what I want. Nope. Oh, here we go. Now it's doing it. But it doesn't usually. Oh, maybe no. No. Oh, here we go. It's a little stuck. I'm sorry. You can go down through the list and see all the points that are in your active flight plan. So final approach fix, standard runway 340 feet. Then to Gilney intersection, which would be the nav 8 for your hold on the missed approach procedure. Okay, so this is done. And if you go to flight plan now, you will see that it shows you the entire approach from Guano interception as your initial approach fix via coquette, and then to your final approach course with Folic being the final approach fix. If we zoom out a bit, you will see that you have a Gilney intersection here. The dashed lines represent your missed approach procedure. Okay, this is pretty much it. Now you have two more options, and if you go to procedure, you can either activate it or do vectors to final. Let's say we will fly it that way, activate the approach, okay, enter, and it will give you a direct track to Guano as to your initial approach fix, from there on to coquette and your final approach course. And if I unfreeze the sim here for just a little bit, you will see that your indications here information have changed to 6 nautical miles to Guano interception right here, 3 minutes en route, desired track is 174, so we'll obviously have to correct a little tiny bit to the left. Estimated time of arrival at Guano would be 19:15 local, and so on. Now, one more thing. If you would go ahead and activate vectors to final, it will go ahead and eliminate every point prior to your final approach fix. Okay, it does it for some reason. It probably thinks that, well, if he's requesting vectors to final, ATC will vector him, and why would he care about previous fixes before the final approach fix or before the final approach course? Here's the fix, and here was the interception of the final approach course leading to the final approach fix. So this is probably how it's thinking, so it will eliminate everything. And if you wanted these points back, you would basically have to go through select approach again, RNAV, enter, and activate or load. You cannot change that by going through back to activate approach. It won't do it. You have to reload it and then do it. Okay, activate approach. Again, we'll do it like this. Here you have your points back, your fixes. So all you only have to do is activate approach, enter, and unfreeze the sim. And it should do it. Okay, so I hope that this was a helpful video. And remember, it's GPS. If you're not using it for a while, you will lose your routine in it. So fly an approach, RNAV approach, or GPS approach once in a while to stay in your routine before you get stuck up there. Have fun flying. Thanks for watching, and see you later. Bye.